one thing about God, he doesn't lie. Now, Satan's wrath that God is allowing is going to come in the form of a trinity. And we can always know that it's Satan because it's always going to operate in an exact opposite mockery of God. He's always going to come as the opposite of God and in a way that mocks God, so as that people redirect their praise and worship to Satan instead of God. So God is the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Satan will come as his own trinity, the dragon, the beast, and the false prophet. God is the one who is, who was, and who's to come. Satan is the beast that was and is not and yet is. This is the satanic trinity. Now, Babylon is where the Antichrist will rise from, because Babylon rides the beast. The Antichrist is under the power and command of America. Now, the beast has seven heads, which are seven kings of seven nations. The Antichrist is already here, and you do all know who he is and have heard of him, but he's not one particular person. Five are fallen, one is, and the other is not yet come. He's got seven heads on this beast. The beast is the Antichrist. Six of these people are already here. Look, Satan is weak. It's not one single person who's going to be able to pull this off. He needs seven heads. He needs seven kings to be able to bring this in. So NATO is going to be a big part in this new world order. Five are fallen, one is, and the other is not yet come. And when he cometh, he must continue a short space. And the beast, even he is the eighth and is of the seven. So of these seven, there is one particular one, a specific king, who will be the main facilitator of the apocalypse. You feel me? So imagine how Jesus works. That's how the Antichrist will try to work and mimic, through worldly things like the technology. Alright, and the technology is going to slowly start to merge. Like with this virtual reality, we're slowly merging the dimensions now, where it's starting to get like how the Matrix, you know, literally we're getting on that level where the technology is starting to merge into the spiritual realm, and the people who are oblivious to it, who are going to be using it and on board with it, are going to be the atheists, the ones who think all this is a random accident and they evolved and there is no God, so they're gonna not see all this stuff. They're not gonna realize they're under Satan's spell. It's a mass hypnosis, it's a mass spell on the world, a curse that everyone's under and placed under at birth, because this is Satan's world. Corinthians 4:4. You're born into this world, and then once you go through this system of, you know, going through the system, getting your driver's license, obeying the laws of the land, once you go through that system, you are agreeing to pretty much selling your soul. Because once you're born, you're assigned a second identity, which is a property title. You actually become property. That's how they trick you into the system. You're under Satan. You got to step out of it and rise above spiritually, because nothing of the flesh or physically matters. But when this technology starts to merge and get to the point of virtual reality and people are going into other worlds and actually being there in the video games and in the movies, you know what I'm saying? It's going to slowly get to that point. And once it does, that's when you know Satan's sneaking in, because AI is the vessel for Satan and the Antichrist to manifest in and have their power with. You feel me? You know, once this stuff starts to happen with this AI and it gets so advanced, and they already have this, they're just waiting to roll it out. They already got this secretly, because they're 44 years ahead with the technology, the military and government. But when they start to put this out on the people, and they're going to slowly increment it, it's going to pretty much be to the point where those, you know, the demons are going to be able to come in to the vessel, AI, and they're going to have direct access to anyone. Anyone who isn't saved, they're going to have direct access to people through AI, and it's going to be a mass possession on the earth. Now, getting back to the Antichrist, it consists of seven kings who are all under the control of Babylon. And of those seven kings, there's one specific one who is going to start the apocalypse, going to be the main facilitator of the apocalypse, like I said. And we're going to know who that main one is, because there's going to be an assassination attempt on their life that they will survive. So the seven kings under Babylon means NATO is part of this Antichrist embodiment. It's a big part. Like, NATO would be the body of the beast. And they're going to be completely based, NATO, they're going to be completely based on super AI technology here soon that they already have right now, but they're waiting to roll out until after all the destruction. That's how they're going to gain their power. Okay, so AI and NATO, AI is the vessel for Satan and the Antichrist to manifest into our world with. Discover aliens. CERN is going to be what tears the veil between the spiritual and physical. They're going to open up the gates of hell and say that they found aliens from other planets and all this BS, man. Listen, they're going to stage an alien invasion, and then they're going to stage the second coming with the Antichrist being the savior who everyone thinks is Jesus. Everything's ass backwards in Satan's world, man. I'm telling you. The two witnesses who are going to start giving their testimony any day now, because they have to come onto the stage and they have a certain number of days to give their testimony, and they're unstoppable and invincible within that time period, and they have to come right before the Antichrist. So we know it's going to be any day that these two witnesses are going to step onto the scene, and everyone's going to think that these two witnesses are the Antichrist. Right? You see how Satan and just screws with everyone's heads? Because we know the Antichrist himself is about to come. So, of course, the Antichrist and Satan's going to fool everyone into thinking these two witnesses, God's angels, God's messengers, who are going to warn the world one last time. And they're going to be so bold and be able to perform miracles like no one's ever seen before. But Satan and 90% of the world who follows him, Satan's going to have them tricked into thinking these godly angels bringing forth their testimony of Jesus, he's going to have them thinking that everyone's going to think they're the Antichrist. Look, God and his people that he sends aren't going to tell you what you want to hear. They're going to tell you what you need to hear, and in a way that you need to hear it best. You feel me? So once their testimony is up and completed, the whole world is going to demand that these people be stopped and killed, these two witnesses. So once their testimony's up and they're no longer untouchable, because it's already written, this has to happen. Whoever kills these two witnesses, the one who kills them, he is the true Antichrist. And this is going to happen any day now. And the whole world's going to praise and thank him for killing these two angels. And they're going to follow him and his tricks straight into hell, man. It's getting crazy. It's getting crazy. It's getting wild, man. And these two witnesses are going to, like I said, they're going to speak in a way that, you know, the truth hurts and people ain't going to like it. It's going to be tough love. And, you know, they're going to come in a way that people least expect it. It's not going to be in any form that people would ever suspect it. It's going to be the one you least expected. And these two witnesses are going to preach of God and his word and warn the world of what's about to come. And right after they get killed, everything they say and they preached about is going to immediately come true. And the whole world, that's God's judgment and his wrath coming down at that point. Okay, that's when it's going to happen. Doing that, but it will all sink in later in time once they die, once they're killed by the true Antichrist. Now, the alien invasion that happens is actually the second incursion of the Nephilim, the giants. When they discover aliens, that is the Antichrist right there. Because these aliens are actually demons, because there is no space or any other planets. Okay, when they announce that these aliens are real and are coming, they're coming from a different dimension, the only other place they can come from, hell. They're demons in disguise, man. What happened was the fallen angels came down and mated with the humans and impregnated them, and the result were these hybrid half-human, half-angelic giant Nephilim things. You know, they were giants walking on this earth, but they were demonic and evil because the fallen angels did that against God's will. That's why God flooded the earth, because the giants were ravaging and destroying it. The evil had peaked and taken over. And what does God say about the end times? He says that as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the coming of man, in the Son of Man. Now, in the days of Noah, right before the flood, Noah was preaching this stuff. Everyone called him crazy, and they were just going about their days. And it came and hit them with like a surprise. Even though they had the warning over and over again, it hit them like a surprise. People were just going about their lives. Everything was normal and as it should be, and then bam. And that's what's about to happen again, because as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be when Jesus is about to return and the apocalypse and Armageddon unfolds. We're here, baby. This is it. Let's get it. It's exciting, man. Woo! So these Nephilim demons, when they got wiped out, they were only killed physically, but the spirit still needed a shell to enter. So us being God's creation and having a soul, when we die, we go to heaven or hell. These things, they don't have souls. These giants, they don't have souls. So aliens are the disembodied spirits of these Nephilim giants. And that's why they all look the same, like they're identical clone aliens. They have no soul. That's why we all got characteristics and stuff, because we're God's creation. We have souls. We are angelic beings at our core. These things, they're just shells for the demons, okay? Pretending to be aliens from other planets and outer space. No, man. No, that's the grand delusion, the great deception. And that is why flat earth is so important, because it exposes all this, because all this can only be justified once you consider, okay, we're a globe, we're a ball, we evolved, we're an infinite possibility, and there's all these aliens and possibilities of life on other planets. It's like, if you take into consideration of God, everything I just said nullifies God's word in the Bible, because it opens up the doorway to, okay, well, who created the aliens over there? If we're God's creation and he only created us and we're special, where did these aliens come from? So it immediately plants the seed, and it wings out God right away. You know what I'm saying? This is Satan's grand delusion, and people are going to believe it because of the technology. Okay, we're slowly being indoctrinated, and people are going to start thinking we are gods in ourselves because of what we can do with this technology and the trickery and the foolery. We're already seeing it right now with the flat earth. The globe and how they cover it up, it's really simple. It's really like once you look into it and find out the earth is flat, because you will, and let's just hope that it ain't after you die. But you're going to find out the earth is flat, and when you do, you're going to feel so stupid and be like, how did I ever believe that? And it's really hilarious, man. It's freaking funny. Hilarious, dude. It's freaking crazy. I mean, I feel embarrassed for people who still believe in the globe 100% and are defending something they have never looked into. You feel me? But the technology, it has everyone convinced already. Even though it's so simple and you can just look past it, but it's the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of Truth is the Holy Spirit, and no one has that. So they're being fooled by the mass deception. They're born into a curse and they never wake up. All right, that's how it is, man.